Oh, man. Well, hopefully this is as exciting as y'all thought it'd be. What I got going on right here is chalice number 10 of 10 for the Order of St. John. This is the last one in the order. I should say in the project. I'm going to take a break here. I think we got a decent picture, don't we? Do I need to zoom out a little bit? Zoom in? Well, at least we're centered. Huh? Now, in case there's any engravers out there watching this is actually just pewter. Hand spun, molded. However, Danforth pewter does it. And now y'all know what I mean when I say, "Hey, I'm just making chips." Chips. Little bitty chips. Oh, and there can't be that many people excited to see this. Oh, and Zane, that's a computer-printed transfer of my rendition of their original artwork. And they sent me pictures of the last remaining chalice, as some of you know. Manufactured in 1665. Hand-engraved silver. They sent me pictures of the very last one they've got. And then I kind of had to make it up as I went. I hope you all don't mind, but I'm going to try and get a bunch of this done before I start answering a bunch of questions. And even if you do mind, tough, it's my page. No, Mr. Bagini, that is not a tattoo. Although I'm pretty sure if you want it to be, it can be. You notice I can rotate it, and I can spin it all at the same time. Yes, dear, I did figure it out. Thank you. I'm only mostly inept. Maybe the next video I'll do something fun, like, you know, 1911 or something. Holy crap, I got 22 people? 24 people watching this crap. Really? Man, you guys must be bored. And the view you're watching right now is just about what I see through my scope. Just about. I don't have that weird yellow showing up through my scope, though, which I'm thinking is my phone because it flashes in and out. There you go, Kevin. Just for you, buddy. Now, and if you do have any other questions, my wife is on here, and she might be able to answer them for you while I'm doing this. Hi, Tiffany. And Kendra. And yes, I saw Eric Janesse on there, and Brian Carroll, and a whole passel of people that are really bored this evening. case anybody's curious of what I'm using, it's a Lindsay Classic with foot control air graver. You can just wander out to airgraver.com and take a look at it. Oh, this is a tiny little air-powered jackhammer. I basically push the gas and steer it. Now, if you're wondering what the graver geometry is for some of you out there, this is Lindsay's Universal with a highly polished heel on it. So it'll run through this very soft pewter. And if you're wondering why this looks frosted, that's a bit of clay, modeling clay, I dabbed out over top of my transfer so it's not so shiny right in my eyeballs. We're still centered in there? Not too bad. Just in case a bunch of you out there were curious about why it takes so long to do something like this. Well, now you know. Get my big hairy arm out of the way. Sorry about that. In case you're wondering how big this piece is I'm working on. Yes, that's actually a penny. There you go. Hey, Keith Pedersen stopped in. I've got the air pressure turned way down on this. I've got the stroke length on this turned way down on this. I'm very partial to a very short, polished heel. And since this material is so soft, you really can't go hammering on it a bunch. If you're wondering why I'm twisting and turning the graver as I go, this will give it a little more flash and basically bling when I'm done with it and get it polished out some more. Kind of like the boys do with the Western bright cut on the belt buckles and the spurs and the bits. We're just doing it on pewter. It's not really the same thing, but sorta. Sorry, I had to reach for the penny there, Zane. And in case you're wondering, by looking at the one hand, that the fingers are cut out of this glove, yes, I am wearing cotton gloves. Because I found after, like, the first chalice I did that my fingerprints on raw pewter don't want to come off. I still got people here. Ta-da! Aren't we excited? I'll try and get a better camera mount the next time I do this. It is, of course, if, you know, unless everybody unfriends me because I'm, like, boring and... Or if you really want to blame anybody for this, blame it on Catherine Plummer. She pretty much started the idea in my head. And there's still people here. If you're wondering why I'm not making complete circles with this thing, the very part of this chalice I'm working on is clear up towards the open top. There's like another 10 inches of it hanging out the back side, and getting it to swing all the way around without running into something is just kind of a pain in the butt. Which I usually can swing it just fine, but I normally don't have my phone over here taking video of it, so... If you're going to use me as an example, I am a bad one. Get back up there. Sorry about that. Oh, man. Midget biker nuns. Awesome. Pictures or it didn't happen, Zane. In case you're wondering, yeah, you are seeing me rotate the cup two directions at the same time. Back here on the very base of it, I've got my thumb, and I'm basically driving it like a little steering wheel back here. So as I turn into the cut, I rotate it into the cut. try and get my line. All right. Whee! Dan, it's really not that exciting. Besides, I think when this is all said and done, it goes ahead and saves this so you can go back and look at it again if you wish. I don't know why you'd want to, but... Just in case we get some of the purists out there. There, I turned off the air. That's with no power. So, if there's ever a question to, well, do you use powered equipment? Yeah, I do. But I can also do it like this. And I can show you hammer and chisel, but not on pewter. So, kind of like building a house, which is faster, using power tools or not? Connor is asking you questions. Well, tell him, Grandma. Explain it all to him. By the way, Connor is my grandson, in case you were wondering. He's sitting there with Grandma watching the same video. I must be more fun than Disney if he's sitting there watching this. How did we get so far out of focus? We're off the picture. The other grandson's watching too. Hi, Leon. Sorry if it isn't turning on center real easy. Well, it's heavy, Dan. I mean, with all the grunting, it's heavy. Actually, I'm kind of being a contortionist back here. I'm going to have to get a different camera rig. Phone rig, whatever. Look at that nice, sexy curl. Thanks, honey. Appreciate it. Thank you.